感谢谢那些读圣经的，谢谢哈。
Thank our brothers and sisters for reading.
那这个23章跟24章哦，是耶稣亚临终的勉励啊，临死前对百姓的勉励。
Chapters 23 and 24 are words of encouragement before he passes on.
那我给他一个题目，叫做哦，耶稣亚告别的讲道啊，告别的讲道也叫做最后的讲道。
Therefore, entitled this Joshua chapter 23 Farewell Address or the Farewell Sermon.
讲完这个道理过后，他就去世了，而且再也听不到他的讲道了。
After these final words, he would have passed on and you would never hear from him again.
所以这两篇呢，应该就是更珍惜了，应该感觉到更加的宝贵了。
And therefore, these two chapters have become all the more precious to us.
好，我们从第一节看，第一节到第五节，这是第一段。
Verses 1 to 5 is our first passage.
哦，他要临死自己知道哦要死了，所以赶快召集以色列的官长，就是领导层啊，带领国家、带领百姓的那些官长来交代事情，来讲道给他们听。
Joshua knew very well that his time was about to come, and therefore he quickly summoned all the leadership level of all Israel, the elders, leaders, judges, so that he could address his sermon to them.
那这篇道理，如果是你，你要给他放什么题目呢？最后的讲到他的题目要放什么呢？
If it was you, then how would you entitle this final farewell sermon?
我从他讲到的内容啊，我看到题目可以放“神为以色列人所行的事”。最后的讲到的题目叫做“神为以色列人所行的事”。
And I can entitle this according to the content of his sharing. These are the works of God, for Israel.
那简单说就是历史的回顾，或者叫做恩典的回顾，回顾神的恩典。
And in simple words, they are to reminisce the grace and blessings of God.
让我们永远记得，常常记得神怎样为我们，神为我们做了什么事情。
So that we'll remember forever, the works of God for us.
神为你做了什么事？神为教会做了什么事？
What did God do for you? What did God do for the church?
那么第一节就看到神使到以色列人过着平静安稳的生活，平安稳定的生活。
First one, we can see that the Lord God has allowed Israel to have a life of rest and peace.
那今天有这种生活呢？这里说是神给的神使到他们有这样的生活，这样的平安。
For them to be able to have this kind of lifestyle was given by God that they are able to have peace and rest.
其实这个是不容易的事，
And indeed, this is not easy.
因为他们的环境还有敌人存在，周围都是敌人来的。
Because surrounding them, there are many enemies around them.
在敌人众多的周围当中，要平安生活、平静生活，这是非常非常不容易的事。这肯定就是神给的才能够。
For them to still be able to live a life of peace and rest, with all their enemies prowling around them, this is definitely no easy feat.
因为这里说神制服了那些仇敌，让仇敌不敢乱来，不敢动这些以色列人。
Because here it says that the Lord God has subdued all his enemies, that they will not touch Israel.
所以，我们从耶稣亚的第一个交代的是第一点讲到的内容，我们来看我们今天的生活，我们真教会在这个世界的这种处境，我们真耶稣教会在这个马来西亚这样的处境。
From the first point of Joshua's final sermon, we can see and reflect our situation in Trujillo's church in Malaysia,
或者在这个世界，
and also in this world.
周围都是敌人，周围都是要攻击我们，要吞噬我们，要对付我们，不是这样吗？
Aren't we threatened by so many enemies around us?
我们成为独居的民，就是很孤独的。外教会什么也不能够，也没有什么来往，也根本没有来往的。那跟其他的宗教那更糟糕了。
We're set as a separate nation, as a holy nation, and we don't even associate ourselves with our Christian denominations out there.
那又加上现在这种灾难，这种疫情，这种各种的灾难。
And on top of that, we have natural disasters and a pandemic ambushing us.
我们能够平静安稳生活，这是神所赐的，大家要记得，大家要感恩，大家要承认这件事。
For us to be able to live our life in peace and rest, this is indeed a blessing from God, and we need to give thanks for that.
这是耶稣亚最后讲到的第一个重点，先提出这一个。
In his final sermon, Joshua pointed out this first important point.
虽然平静安稳生活，其实就是很平凡的生活，一天又一天，一天又过一天，很平凡，甚至是你觉得很枯燥的生活。
What is this life of rest and peace? These are indeed a life of ordinary life living from day to day.
其实这个就是最需要的，也是最宝贵的。
And indeed, this is actually the most needed and most precious.
你看现在疫情了，管制令来了，我们一直关在家里了，这里不能去，那边不能去，甚至连office也不能去，很多事情不能做的时候，哎，你就发现到我们平时的生活原来就是这么宝贵的，原来是这么需要的，就是很需要的。
It is only with the MCO set in place that we realize our normal days were so precious, and we need to live our lives as normal, to go to work, to live our day as we please, and that was normal life.
所以我们经历了这样的岁月，这样的这种疫情，我们应该醒悟过来，感谢神，原来平时的生活，平安的生活，我们认为很枯燥的生活，就是我们最需要。
And these are the days that we have to reflect on. These are the days of rest, which even tend to be boring and tend to be mundane. But these are the things that we actually need.
那么接下去说，耶稣也年纪老迈了。Here
it goes on to say that Joshua was well advanced in age.
那么他这个时候呢，已经110岁了。
At this time, he was already 110 years old.
我们怎么知道呢?
How do we know that?
因为在24章29节的时候，他就在这110岁的时候死了。Because
he died in chapter 24, verse 29, at the age of 110.
我们看到一个英雄，一个神国的英雄，一个勇士，也经不起岁月的摧残，时间的这种摧残。
We can see that even the hero of the kingdom of God has not been able to defeat the attack from age and death.
每个人都要经过这一条路，要走到这一段的。And
everyone has to pass through this stage.
所以14节说，我现在要走世人要走的路，每一个人都要经过这条路。
Which is why verse 14 he said that he was about to go on the way of all the earth. Everyone should go.
我们的生命会慢慢的枯萎，我们的身体肉体会慢慢的衰败，会慢慢的很多很多软弱的事，很多心有余力不足的事情，我们都要经过这样，一定会这样子。
This is where our fleshly life will be to wither, and also our body will deteriorate.
所以我们趁着还可以的时候，还年轻的时候，或者有力的时候，赶快做神要我们做的，或者赶快做你还未做的，神要你做的，你赶快做。
Therefore, we have to tell ourselves to seize hold of the opportunity while we are still, we still have our vitality, our energy to do whatever that has to be done.
其实你不用想到神到底要我做什么，要做什么伟大的事，要做什么很大的事，其实都不用，你不用想到这么远。
We don't have to think too far about such those great things that God might want us to do.
神要我们做的很简单，就是我们敬拜他，来爱他，爱人，爱神。 尽我们的力量来去机会侍奉他，就是这样而已啊，这样就已经很好了，神就很满意了。God,
all that God wants from us is to love Him and to worship Him and to in all our capacity, and that is already satisfying to God.
所以第二节，他把那些助长领导人招来的时候，再对他们说：“我年纪已经老了，很多事情我没办法做了。” 甚至再慢一点，连讲话都已经不能了。
Verse 2, having summoned all the leaders of the Israel, Joshua told them that I'm so old, and if you came a little later, I wouldn't be able to speak, I even can't speak.
三节到五节呢，就是他开始哈啊述说神的恩典了，神曾经为他们做的事情了。
Verse 3 to verse 5, he was addressing the works that God has done for us.
第一，这些主的恩典呢，主的同在呢，是我们亲眼所见的，亲身经历、亲眼看到的，看到吗？第三节。
Verse 3, that we have indeed seen everything, all this grace and blessings of the Lord God are done on us.
就是说我们今天的信仰哦，不是只是听说、听传道说、听执事说，我们自己也是真真实实的体验到，甚至亲耳听到神说话，亲眼看到神同在，这个是真真实实的、实实在在的信仰。
That's to say that our faith is not just hearsay, it's that we have experienced this truly and real and genuinely in our everyday life.
你的信仰到现在是不是实实在在呢？还是一直都在听人家讲、听人家讲，你自己没有感受、没有经历呢？
Is your faith true and genuine to your own experience, or is it just by your hearsay?
那第二。
Secondly,
神是为我们以色列人征战的，看到吗？神是为我们征战，不是为别人征战的，看到吗？
The Lord our God is one who fought for us, who fights for us, but not for the others.
第三节的中间呢？
The latter portion of verse 3.
那若不是神为我们征战，我们不可能得到这个应许之地，我们也不可能现在住在迦南地，住在神的国里面，不可能。
If not for God who has fought for us, then we wouldn't be able to stay in this promised land of Canaan. Impossible.
所以我们重新在从耶稣亚的讲道当中，再一次的对神产生了更大的信心。神为我们征战，所以你不用怕，不是你一个人在征战，不是你一个人在对付敌人，神为我们征战。
In the final sermon of Joshua, we find out and we are reminded again that our Lord God is the one who is fighting for us, but not us fighting our own battle.
那么再接下去的，他继续说，神也吩咐我将地分给你们十二个支派，意思说我们现在大家都得到土地，都拥有土地了。
Verse 4 tells us that now that God has allotted this land for our inheritance, we all have an inheritance of this land.
那意思说神的应许没有落空哦，都照着他的应许给了我们哦，大家都已经得到了。
It goes to say that the promise of God did not go empty, and all of us have received what we have been promised.
这个是他的第三个重点。
That's a third important point.
那第四个重点是什么呢？
Fourthly,
就是在第五节，神会继续的将其余还未赶出去的敌人或者外族人，神还继续会帮我们继续的赶出他们。
For the rest of the enemies around us, the Lord our God will drive them out of our way.
这是在第五节。
In verse 5.
那么也一个现实就是说，耶稣也一百多岁了，从他年轻打仗打到他一百多岁呢。还有敌人没有赶出去哦，还为这个工作没有完全的，还没有完成呢，还没有。
That's to say that the battles that Joshua has been fighting since in the days of his youth until old age, even then this work has not been fully completed.
所以这个是个很漫长的一种工作，很漫长的一个信仰的临战，信仰的战争。
Therefore, this is a very long and enduring a spiritual battle of our faith.
这个也从这里看出耶稣亚的信心，虽然我做不到了，我年纪我要死了，可是神一定会继续的帮助我们，将这些工作完成，将敌人赶出去，会继续的帮助我们。
These words project his faith towards God, that although now he is well advanced in age, and he is no longer able to do it, but God will still take the work from his hands and continue.
这个就是信心哦。
That is faith.
这个就是交托了，交托给神了。
That is entrusting to God.
所以我们教会领导成为长职传道，我们教会的领导了，这个圣职人员，我们看管苏邦教会，看管这个俄麦教会，你不要以为只是你一直在做，你在带领，不是， 我们很多东西做不到，甚至还没有完成，到今天都还没有做到什么，也没有完成什么。但是你要有信心，神一定会帮助我们。我虽然做不到，但是神会做到。是，我虽然帮不到，但是神一定会帮到。
The leadership level or the committee of the church, both in Gombak and Subang churches, we have to realize this, that we are not actually the ones who have been working hard, but it was by God's work. And in the things that we can't and we no longer can do, the Lord God will still be helping us later.
这个是从耶稣呀最后讲道当中他提出的一个信心，一个教导。
That is the message that Joshua pointed out in the sermon.
那其实也有神的旨意啦，这个敌人这么久还没有消灭掉，因为神有讲啦，要借助这些还剩下的这些敌人来考验以色列人，来提醒他们，他们一不听话呢，这些敌人就会去对付他们，他们一离开神的道理呢，这些敌人就会伤害他们，所以他们一直很警醒，一直要亲近神。
Even in this matter, that was the will of God as well. The reason why these enemies have been left and not driven out just yet was also to test the faith of the rest of the Israelites, lest they fall away and they deny God. Then the enemies will attack and devour them.
那到六节到十一节呢？是啊，这里是什么呢？
Verse 6 to 11, what does this tell us?
这里有一个很严重、很严重的警告。
Here's a very severe and stern warning.
警告以色列民，今后的我死过后了，以后的祸还是福，全在于看我们有没有遵行神的律法。以后呢，是得到福气，还是灾难临到，就看我们有没有遵行神的律法。它的整个重点。
The central message of this stern warning is that in the days to come after Joshua has left, whether you are to receive a blessing or a woe or a curse from God, it is all up to the works of your works in obeying the law of Moses.
第六节
Verse 6.
你们要大大壮胆，谨守摩西所写的一切律法。什么叫做大大壮胆呢？
What does that mean to be very strong to obey the book of the law?
大大壮胆原文有要下定决心的意思，要下定很大的决心来遵守神的话，遵守摩西的律法，要用很大的决心，我要这样做，我一定要这样做。
Be very strong and full of courage is in the original text to mean that one has been fully determined and resolved to complete this.
这个就是我们新年每一个新年的时候常常讲的道理旧的让它过去，软弱的让它过去，失败的让它过去。新的一年，我要下定决心，我要立志，我要机会，我要爱神，我要怎么样，我要怎么样，是吗？这个是新年每一年都讲的道理对不对？
In every new year, we share these encouraging sermons about let the past, let the old pass us by, and we will be resolute for new things in this new year.
那么你们英文是不是讲大大壮胆也是讲大大壮胆吗？还是有另外的意思？
对，是的，是的。
那原文是要下定决心，要很大的决心来做这件事。
And in Chinese and English translation, be very strong, be very courageous. In the original text, it just means that we have to be very resolute.
那请注意，当你遵守神的律法的时候呢，你要注意一点，不可偏离左右。意思说。你不可以热心过度的属灵过度的，这个不可以，那个不可以，然后一直去，好像自己已经过度了，已经过浓了，热心过浓了，那也不可以向左向左也是偏离了。我们就是要不偏左不偏右的中中庸庸的从从容容的走在神的道路上，神的律法上。
Here it tells us that without turning aside to the right or to the left, that actually goes to mean that we cannot be overly zealous and overly enthusiastic, so driven to the point that we become too spiritual, overly spiritual, and then we want to take control of the words of God. That's not right either.
因为我们也有热心过度，所谓热心过度就是已经偏了，已经不正常了，结果走迷了，走歪了。结果被魔鬼留地步了， 那个也是不对的哦，凡事都有节制的哈，都有它的节奏的哈。
There are also sometimes where we become overly enthusiastic, overly zealous, and want to, and we become the foot, we become the we fall into the trap of the devil.
那么好，我们就要就是走不偏左右了。当我们说我们要遵行神律法的时候，我们的心要很谨慎啊，要很清洁。我不走偏，我也不走右，我也不走左，
As we
照着次序来走，照着正常来走就对了。
keep the commandments of God, we ought to have a heart of a heart of self-control and be at moderation in terms of our ways of keeping the words of God. We ought to not turn to the right, not turn to the left.
那7节跟12节呢？交代呢？警告呢？不可以跟剩下的外族人，就是敌人掺杂，特别是指婚姻哦，不可以哦。
Verse 7 and verse 12 tells us that we should not associate or be mingled, be yoked together with the foreigners, especially in marriage.
那12节哦，12节特别讲哦。不要跟他们结亲，互相来往，因为会影响我们的信仰啊，会
Verse
跟
12
从他们去拜偶像啊，重点是在这里
Verse 12 tells us that we ought not intermarry with them, but the main point was that we might turn away and from God and to their idols.
那第七节说，连外邦人的神，他们拜的神哦，连提都不可以提，连讲都不要去讲，提他们的名都不要提。就是
Verse
完全
7.
跟我没有关系的。
Even tells us not to even invoke the names of their gods and the idols. That's to say, not even to talk about, to mention their names and have no th nothing to do with them.
连他们神的名都不提，意思说我很讨厌的，我提到都很讨厌的，这个就是忌邪的心啊，圣洁的心。
And this is also not to invoke the names of their idols, meaning to say that we have a holy God, a holy heart, for God.
那第8节说，要我们专心依靠神，专心，看到吗？专心靠神。
Verse 8 tells us that we ought to hold fast to the Lord our God.
那第10节呢？如果当我们有这样靠神的时候，这样呢，神就一定会为我们征战。第10节。
Verse 10 that if we are able to do that, then our Lord God will fight for us and we will rout a thousand.
怎么样知道神会为我们征战呢？我还没有讲，你就讲了，喂，兄弟，你照我的话翻译吧。怎样知道神跟我们征战呢？怎么知道呢？
How do we know that our Lord God will fight for us?
你看呢，一个人必追赶千人，这是不可能的事情啊！你一个人怎么可以打千人，而且胜过千人？
It says one of you routs a thousand. How can one fight a thousand army?
你再厉害也不可能啊！
No matter how strong you are, you might not be able to do that.
这说明神为我们征战哦，神在帮助我们
It shows that the Lord God has been fighting us, fighting for us, and helping us.
那从以色列人的战争史上哦，有没有这样的事？有没有这样的见证？
In the history of Israel fighting wars, don't you have this testimony?
我们多几天哦，多几两个礼拜哦，我们就会读到史诗记，你就会看到这种神迹了，这种神同在的神迹了。
In 2 weeks to come, we will be going into the book of Judges. You will be able to see this miracle.
一个人一个事实，一个人好像参孙，打几百人几千人，一个人而已哦，一个人可以追赶千人，就是真的发生了，真的发生。
Just one judge, Samson, was able to fight and rout 1,000 people. This is to testify these very words of Joshua.
不只是参孙啊，其他的事实也是这样啊。
Not just Samson, there are also other judges who did that.
为什么会有这样的神迹？
Why do we have such miracle?
因为第8节说，我们专心靠神，我们没有办法靠自己，我们就靠神，而且很用心靠神，很专一的靠神，神就跟我们行这个神迹。
That's with the context of verse 8 that we are able to first hold fast to God and serve God wholeheartedly.
那11节，
11.
除了专心靠神，还要做什么呢？
What else do you have to do other than holding fast to God?
我们要分外谨慎的爱我们的神，要特别爱我们的神。
To be very careful to love our Lord, our God.
这个是耶稣亚临终的时候所讲的道理，我称它为最后的讲道。
This is what I call and entitled as the final address or the final sermon of Joshua.
其实现在我们的长子传道们还没有死，还很年轻，我们就不断讲这种道理了，不是吗？重复又重复，提醒又提醒，我们还没有死就一直在讲啊，好像我现在就一直在讲呀。
For us, elders and ministers, or preachers and deacons, we have been speaking of these sermons even before we are old and advanced in age.
所以因为一直讲哦，所以人家听到厌了，听到烦了。传道你可以讲别的嘛，我听到厌了，从小听到大。
And because we have been talking about this kind of content, and members become bored of it because they have been listening since young.
好，我们看最后一段，
Look at the final passage.
就是12节到16节。
Verse 12 to 16.
这一段是在讲呢，如果我们违背神的诫命，我们一定遭遇到很可怕的祸患，就是在这一段讲。
And here it tells us that if we go against the commandments of God, then we will be destroyed.
我们从12节跟13节看到最严厉的警告，最严重的警告。
Verse 12 and verse 13 tells us of the most stern warning.
还有那个15、16节也是一样，重复12、13节的内容。
Verse 15 and 16 also repeats of the content in verse 13.
这里说呢，如果我们违背神的律法呢，我们会落在网罗里面，这个哦，这个被魔鬼的网罗，被世界的这种网罗，被偶像的网罗，牵扯到全部网中，我们跑不出来。
It tells us that if we were to turn against from the words of God, we would have fallen into the snare of the evil one, the devil.
成为我们肋上的鞭啊，我们身上哦，一直很痛苦啊，好像有鞭在打我们，眼中有刺。你看看你的眼中有沙粒，不是很痛吗？意思说这些痛苦在我们的身上，在我们的家里，在我们的人生，在我们的生活，非常痛苦，让我们非常痛苦。
It would become whips on your back and also thorns in your eyes, which describe to us the kind of pain and suffering that we will go through.
不单止非常痛苦，一直到我们在这个地上灭亡啊。直到死啊，也是这样痛苦啊，看到吗？
Not only will you bear with this kind of pain, it is until you perish from this good land, until you die.
所以我说这一段圣经呢、啊，这里的警告是最严重的警告，因为警告到到我们灭亡为止还是很痛苦的，当我们死还是很痛苦的。
Which is why I'm saying that this is the worst or the most stern warning out of this passage, because it is a suffering unto death.
那到14节，他就说了，做出严重的警、严厉的警告过后，他说无可奈何，因为我要走了，无可奈何，我也没有办法解决生命的问题。
After this stern warning, Joshua came to this helpless statement that he was about to leave this world, and he was not able to resolve the problem of
因
life.
为这生命的问题是在神的手中，神掌握的，神控制的。
Because this problem of life lies in the hands of God, and God has dominion over that.
意思说，我不能够再带领你们了，也不能够再跟你们一同警醒，甚至责备你们了。你们走错的时候，你们拜偶像的时候，我也没有办法再提醒你们了。
That's to say that I'm no longer able to lead you and not even able to rebuke you if you stray away from the right way to worship the idols.
但是我会在我还可以讲话的时候，我还是继续的会这样的督责你们，这样的来带领你们。
While I still have my breath and also be able to speak, I will still be here to give you my final encouragement.
这个是个真正的这个在神在教会中神的工人就应该是这样，才这个才是真正神的仆人。
And this is the manifestation of the true servant of God.
一直讨好人的就不用了啦，因为教会里面有稗子有山羊，你一直讨好这些人，那什么意思呢？他们肯定不喜欢听这种道理的呀，但你一直讨好他们，所
And
谓的
surely,
山羊，所谓的那个。那些拜子就在教会里面呢、啊，你不，那如果连他们都很喜欢你，那等于说你有问题。
Surely we do not need man pleasers and who are just gonna pass favors and also please the crowds or including the tares and the goats of the church.
好了，我们14节，
Verse 14.
14节就说神所应许的话，没有一句是落空的，看到吗？14节，
Not
神给我
one.
们的话，给我们的应许，没有一句做不到的。
Not one of the commandment of the good promises of the Lord God has failed.
神所应许给我们的、给你的、给教会的，都应验在我们的身上，应验在我们的教会里面，应验在我们的信仰当中。
Whatever that has been promised by God for us, for the church, it shall be fulfilled, it shall pass.
然后接下去15、16节都是一样咯，再重复严厉的警告。
Verse 15 and 16 is a repetition of the stern warning.
意思说，神可以将一切福气临到我们，神也可以将一切的祸患灾害临到给我们。
That's to say that God is able to bring blessings to us and also bring disasters and woe on upon us.
而且请注意哦，直到我们灭亡为止，直到死为止哦。
Take note that it will be until we perish to
我在
die.
想啊，如果传到今天我了哈，我如果在台上讲这样严厉的话，说神的灾难一直给你们到你们死为止，我看被人家骂死了，我看总会也会开会来警告我，我相信啊。
I was only wondering that if I were to say these words of Joshua on the pulpit in my sermon and telling you that you will surely die and perish because of this, then the GA might be holding a meeting on my account and
我
talk
这样
about
讲
that.
是有原因、有背景的，有一些根据的，不是没有的。
For me to share this kind of words comes with a reason, it comes with a context.
所以我们讲的道理都不太敢哦，太严厉呀、啊，真的
And
是
now
这样子呀、啊。
we are not bold enough to share stern sermons.
但是你看，中心的仆人在旧约到新约。每一个先知中心不能骂以色列人的时候，警告他们的时候，多可怕呀，多严厉啊！甚至那个施洗约翰说：“你们是毒蛇的种类啊，这个计划太假了的啦。”但是他们就是这样讲的呀，他们就是真的是这样讲的，他们是毒蛇的种类啊，真的是这样呀。
And you look at the Bible and the Old Testament have all these prophets rebuking them with such stern warnings and also even to the point of curses. And even John the Baptist in the New Testament called them the brood of vipers, and they actually said these words.
我们今天失去了旧约先知们的那种勇气，跟那种圣洁的心，那种勇敢的心，我们已经失去了。
Today, what we have
我们
lost is this. Courage of the Old Testament servants of God.
要讲呢，也是轻轻的讲，或者哇，那个大圈啰里啰嗦，哎，你听起来哇，没什么呀，你听到好像是有一点责备，但是感觉到没有什么，还 OK 啊。不会很生气啊，这个就是
Today.
缺少了那种火的力量，那种很强的力量。
Even if we were to bring up some sensitive issues, we will beat around the bush and we will say in a very soft tone, until which people still don't see the impact of it, we have lost this power of this fire.
你自己将心比心啊，你看耶稣啊，他讲的。你们如果离开神的道理，神的祸患一定临到你们，直到你们死，而且你们的生活每天都很痛苦，直到你们死，你敢讲吗？你会
And
讲吗？
Do you dare to say what Joshua said to them that if you do this, if you do wrong, then you will suffer until the day you die?
你这样讲是不是信徒智慧要开会呢？这传道太过分了，说传道一直在骂人了，我们不要了，不要这个传道了，会不会这样呢？
Wouldn't
要
you
有点智慧哦。
call for a meeting at the GA level and to say that we don't want this preacher anymore? He's
我跟你
talking too
讲，每
much.
一个很欣赏传道的呢，一直称赞传道的都是信徒。当他们被选上执事会了，成为执事的，成为传道了，完全就不一样了，就已经不是欣赏我、赞美我、支持我，已经不是了。当你上到上面的时候，就已经不是了。下面的时候，我传道感谢你哦，你很勇敢哦，哇，你讲道很好哦，你敢骂哦，我遭遇太多了，这些太多了，讲不完。
I can tell you the truth that those who are able to really appreciate my tone of sermon are ordinary members. And once they have assumed the role of a person in charge in a church or deacon or a preacher, they will not share the same way of appreciation and they will not be the ones complimenting these sermons.
为什么会改变呢?
Why did they change?
我没有变啊, 道理还是这样。 变的是他们是信徒的时候是这样, 当进入到领导层的时候, 或者长职的时候, 他们变了。
I did not change. My character or my tone had always been like that, but those who changed were them after assuming the new role or the higher role in the church.
但是你可以知道, 传道从做传道也好, 做信徒也好, 都是这样讲到啊，到今天还是这样讲到，没有改变啊。 从开始到现在都是一样的呀。But
you might notice that since I started my ministry as a preacher, I had always been speaking this kind of content.
我是从这里看见耶稣啊讲的这么严厉哦，很严厉的讲到哦，提出这个问题了，大家去检讨一下吧，包括现在的长职负责人，你们自己去检讨一下吧。
I'm only thinking out loud, looking at the words of Joshua, and it's a very, very stern warning. And that's for us to really examine ourselves, including persons in charge and ministers.
另一个让我很感动的这一章呢，啊，二十三跟二十三最让我们感动的是什么？
What is most moving of this chapter 23?
就是这个耶稣呀，哦，他要临死之前，他的内心，他的心还惦记着以色列人。 还惦关心着他们的灵魂得救，他要死的时候还把这件放在最重要的位置上。
And even in the final moments of Joshua before he passed on, he still prioritized the spiritual life of his people in the very first place.
我们会不会这样做呢? 我们的心会不会这样呢?
Would we do that? Would our heart do that?
要死了，也剩下不多时间了，也可能不能够再讲话了。 我趁着我可以讲的时候，我的内心全部都是因为教会，因为信徒，因为信仰，因为灵魂。我还是重点还是放在这里，没有其他。But
rely on the deathbed, or while we are about to breathe our last, would we still, with all our energy left, speak words or even emphasis of the church instead of ourselves?
我们每个做父母的都应该要有这种心。
Every parent should have this kind of heart.
我们要临死之前，或者不能够再讲话之前，我们一直交代我们的孩子：你一定要回教会，你一定要爱你的神，你一定要奉献，你一定要遵守神的道理，你一定要怎么样怎么样，一直交代他。我想这不是我这样做，是每一个父母都要对孩子这样，每一个。
Before we breathe our last, we have to give our best to encourage and to instruct our children to return to God and to walk in the ways of God, and all our parents should do that.
你说你讲了几十年，他都不听了啊，他都已经不听了，就是不听，所以才要讲啊，就是不听到最后一口气，也还是要讲啊，还要救他呀。And
you say that you're. That my children never has listened to me when we talk about this, and that's exactly the reason why you have to keep bringing this up even until the day you die.
有一个很好的见证.
There's a good testimony.
有一个整二十多到三十年没有回来教会的信徒，一个孩子已经整三十年没有到教会.
A child has not come back to church for the past 20 or 30 years.
他妈妈要死的时候，他回来看妈妈了。 妈妈还可以讲，就在床边哦，要断气之前，一直叫他说你要回来教会，而且要他答应，你一定要答应妈妈，讲很小声啊，很小声，很难，要很注意听啊，因为没有力气了。When
the mother was about to pass away and she was on her sick bed and with the little energy that she had left, she whispered to this child.
妈，她说我会，妈妈说你不只是点头，你要答应妈妈。 你一定要回来教会，你要答应妈妈，这是妈妈最后的要求。And
the mother said that this is my final and last request. You don't just nod your head. You must promise me to go back to church.
讲完过后，她妈妈就死了，就断气了。And
these were the last words of the mother before she actually died.
她很感动，她这件事情一直在想，一直在她内心里面一直想，妈妈最后的什么都没有讲，就是要我回教会，这件事情这么重要吗？ 如果不重要，妈妈怎么最后的一句话是这样呢？而且一定要我答应呢
And this
不然
child
妈
was
妈
very
死不瞑目嘛，死都不放心呐，死都不放心。
This child was very moved and very puzzled as well as to why is this so important to her that she has to say this even as this as her final words before she died.
他后来感动了，因为他悔改了。他想到妈妈，我临死前我都做不到，妈妈最后的要求我都做不到，而且这个又很容易做的，不是很难做的。我为什么做不到？为什么不孝顺父母？为什么不听父母？结果他现在一家人啊，他太太是外邦人来的，整家人在教会热心，一直到今天啊，整家人在教会侍奉，因为
At
妈
that
妈
point,
临终的交代。
and because of these very words of the mother before she died, he became very zealous. Then he was even bringing in his Gentile wife and his whole family to come to church. And today they are all very fervent together.
这个就是父母亲的心，对孩子的心。
That is the heart of the mother or the parents to the
那个，
child.
我看到耶稣呀，最后要临终前这样讲话，这样交代，就是把信徒、把百姓当做自己的孩子，这样来爱他们，这样来关心他，这样来担心他们。最后还是要交代他们回到神那边去，最后。
There's also the final encouragement and the final instruction of Joshua before he died, seeing the people of Israel as his own children.
这是耶稣啊最后的讲道，也叫做最后的勉励，叫做最后的遗言。
This is the final sermon, final words and instructions as the final address of Joshua.
要到教会去，回到神的身边。
Go back to church and go back to God.
来一起祷告。
Let's pray.